The microbiome experiment studies the effects of space travel on the human immune system, as well as the microbiome. That's the microbes that live inside and outside of our bodies. I spoke with the investigator of this investigation to see exactly how it works.
The work originally started a few years ago at the recommendation of a science panel, and they had a great deal of interest in the type of organisms that were associated directly with the crew, both on their skin and in their GI tract. And so we put together a solicitation, and it was won by a group at the J. Craig Venter Institute. And we have called it the crew microbiome experiment. And what we're really looking at are the changes that occur into the occurring to the microorganisms on the crew and in the crew that could affect their health.
And we have that on Earth too, right?
Definitely. The National Institutes of Health, NIH, has been putting a great deal of funding. This is a topic that a lot of scientists are very interested in. We've associated your microbial flora with a lot of disease and a lot of your immune factors. And so finding out how it changes in what's healthy flora and what's not healthy flora, and are more people more prone, and can things like spaceflight actually change whether you are more prone to disease or not?
How do we find this out? How does your experiment work?
Basically, we are going to take samples from the crew members, pre-flight, post-flight, and a few samples in flight. We're going to be tracking their diets to see how that might impact what's going on with the flora. We're going to be looking at environmental conditions, humidity, how often they clean, things along the lines of the surfaces they touch. We're going to be looking at those to try to determine, is there an equilibrium between what goes on outside and on and in you? And then try to associate that with certain immunological factors. So we're doing tests on those too to determine, is there an association between the bacteria you have and your immune status?
Is this the first of its kind study in space?
It is the first of its kind, study for NASA. Our Russian colleagues have actually done some studies like this and have done so for several years. And there were things to be learned, but the major difference is over the past few years, biotechnology has expanded tremendously and allowed us a lot of tools that we never had before. And so we're able to look at things completely differently than we did before in a much grander scale. So the analyses we're doing are truly novel from the standpoint of being able to look at a large picture.
I know it's just started, but have you learned anything so far? Anything interesting?
Well, we actually learned a lot from the NIH. A lot of their results came out in June. And so we are able to use a lot of that data as normal data, sort of what do normal people have? And then taking normal healthy people as we do and transporting them to space, it's easier to get a comparison of what would happen on Earth versus what would happen in flight.
How many astronauts do you hope to test, or how many subjects do you have, or how long will this go for?
We are going to keep going until we have 9 subjects. We wanted to make sure that we had enough information to make sure it was statistically relevant. And so we are going to have 9 subjects. And we should have enough information to have a really good understanding of what's going on at that time.